Hi everyone, I am Tutku Karahan and I will present my Introduction to Digital Design course project, considering the environmental factors of sunlight, smoke and rain that disturbs customers. I design an umbrella with a servo motor that turns 180 degrees when it detects light from the direction of light sensor. I also design an awning that works with a servo motor. It turns little less than 180 degrees when the rain sensor detects raindrops. And lastly, I design a fan that starts working if a smoke sensor detects smoke coming from the nearest table.
Here is my project. It's an outside plan of a cafe. Here is the awning. It works with the rain sensor. When the weather is rainy, it closes. Here is the umbrella. It has three parts, and its parts follows the light to prevent the sunlight from customers. When there are smokers sitting at the nearest table, the smoke sensor detects it, and the fan simply starts working to dissipate the smoke. In order to control the servo motors and fan in my project, I divide the frequency of the clock of basis 3, which is 100 MHz, into 4 kHz. 50,000 is the value I obtained for dividing the period. When the counter reaches the half of the period, the temporary signal inverses its value to obtain a 50% duty cycle clock. Here is the code to control the servo motors with the inputs of sensors. PWM signal needs to be generated for the 4 kHz clock. Since the clock gives 1 millisecond each 4 iterations, the period of 20 milliseconds is reached with a counter signal by 80 iterations. Up to period signal is used to reach 20 millisecond period needed for servo. The servo works within 0.5 milliseconds to 2.5 milliseconds pulse width range, so to obtain a 180 degree turn, I use the lowest value of range with 2 iterations and add 8 iterations with the sensor's high input to obtain 10, that corresponds to 2.5 milliseconds, that is for the umbrella's turn. For the awning, little less than 2.5 milliseconds is reached by the same logic. Eight iterations are made here with a counting signal. The multiplexer makes the counting signal 0 when it reaches 80, which is the 20 millisecond period. And active light and active rain signals with sensor inputs are compared with the counting signal to turn the servo motors when they are greater for 2.5 milliseconds and gives output one for servos. Here is the code to control a fan, which is a DC motor controlled with the outputs of smoke sensor. The input start is the inverse of the presence of smoke. So when it's zero, the motor works in either clockwise or counterclockwise direction, depending on the arbitrary choose. Taking the two bit inputs, one is high and one is low, the fan works. The direction of turn for the fan is determined with the multiplexer. And here the sensor output chooses to run the motor or not. And the fan gets its inputs at the rising edge of the clock and keeps it until the next rising edge. I combine the clock divider, the fan and servo motor control modules in a top module. The new clock generated is used in both DC and servo motor control modules with the clock out signal. The circuit of design is shown with the sensor inputs and motor outputs.